All right, we are back with more Metaphor Re Fantastico. This game is fantastico. It's Idols Day.
Oh, it's Goad.
I can't go to the Gauntlet Runner right now. I actually think I'm boned on that. I don't know if I'll be able to go to the Gauntlet Runner tonight either, so I think I'm about to lose that plus one luck.
Oh no, the luck.
Oh no, the poop. Anywhere you want to go, I'll take you to the far bank. Arena Front Wharf. Merchant's Bazaar. That's where you want to go. Yes. Alright, let's buy some shit. It is Idols Day, though, so it's time to buy.
Time to go shopping. Shopping
today. Luck be a tall glass, lad. Buy three more fruit cordials. Welcome to the Briny Deep, where none of our prices be ever too steep. We got fresh fish. You can look in our tank. If you need the if you need the bathroom, take a left to the plank. Follow me, sir. Yeah, sorry. Sorry, Martina. I'm doing good, though. How about yourself? Throw my discount today. Take your time looking around. Defensive medicine. Siren Song Gloss. I've been abusing the hell out of these tin torpors. These are so good. Great Fairy Dust, which is 100 HP to everybody. Right on. Another one of these. Five of these. Life-saving medicine. Don't need that. Nothing left to appraise. Huh, interesting they're letting parapets be shopkeepers.
Greetings.
Yes. Quit the sword. That's your belt. My day's doing pretty good. Just opened some Digimon cards, got some pretty cool stuff out of that. And yet that's quite the sword at your belt. We pride ourselves on being a purveyor of only the finest apparel for the Navy, as well as the local sailors. In addition to clothing, we also sell a variety of unusual accessories. Oceania is not just full of fishmongers, you know. Imports and maritime trade are the key to the business in these parts. Now, let me find something that's absolutely perfect for you, dear. Let me think. Since it's Idol's Day, how about this rider's anklet? My dear customer, do you believe in dragons? This is fashioned in the image of a dragon's wing and imbued with a speed that's truly divine. Sure. Maybe you'll gain a decent amount of speed with it. If it lives up to its name, anyway. Right now, you have zero. What do you want to do? I'll buy it. Rider's Anklet. As expected, you have excellent judgment, and it looks fantastic on you. Every day of the week, I'll be waiting with a new item just perfect for you. Do come again. I play most RPGs and stuff like that. What now? Heroes. I need him to be a stronger commander. I found new power. Fiery Strike. Physical fire damage to one enemy. He needs to be level 13 for what I want to do with him. Alright, Rider's Anklet. Plus 9 agility. That's pretty sweet, actually. Alright, let's see what we can get weapons-wise. Increases fire attack strength. Attack strength. Giant type monster killer. Yeah, RPGs are my favorite kind of games. Fishing harpoon. Usable by the knight. The fucking bougie abacus. That's pretty good. The pearl semaphore. Fortune's bludgeon. The healer. Interesting. Yep, gotta save up for the PCs. I getcha. Yeah, I need to do some upgrading on my PC as well. Now then. This is pretty decent, but friggin'. Right on, right on. This is also awesome. Restores MP upon defeating an enemy during a squad. That might not be too bad. I could give it to him as a healer. Hook him up with that. Then just give him a bunch of high-end magic stuff. Man, that is expensive. I might need to freaking make him a merchant and get some cash. Check out the discounted armor shop. Ah, that's cool, that's cool. Healing hauberk. That is a crazy... Knight and Warrior. Everybody. That was expensive as hell. Wait a minute now. We are broke as hell now. That's not great. That's okay. I don't really have a discerning eye for art. You're the mag broker, huh? I hear a voice in my mind. Healer's exchange, the head is useless as is. Alright, so what is it? So one mag is worth 6 money. Oh, I could get rich as hell. I'll think about it, but I use mag for, well, everything. Okay. Who has mag thievery? Oh, Hulkenberg does, because, you know, he's Hulkenberg. Debt collection. All right. How much mag we talking from this? What's that? Rest of your juice? Mm-hmm. Some apple juice in the freezer again. I was gonna drink apple juice, more apple juice, and even more apple juice. I know he said don't drink so much apple juice, but I'm doing it. I love apple juice. Okay, Angler's in district. Let's go. Oh, damn, the big face in the sky is everywhere.
Yeah, okay.
You can really see the king's face from here. I realized it was slowly moving, but it's coming to Brawlhaven beyond my expectations. I wonder why it came. I do suspect it keeps a watchful eye on the top candidates. It's evident that we're being observed, as we've seen from the Coronation Rock. Well, maybe that's actually for the better. Seeing that thing in the sky might make everyone really think about the kingdom's future. In a way, we'd better get to finding it in, we can say that. Ridiculous. All right, then. What do I do? Oh, that's Morse Phantom. Okay. Should I say this in? Nope. You're a dick. You're a dick. What? Oh, who's in do we stay at? It's tied between this guy in his fancy-ass Hawaiian shirt. And this guy in his douchebag attire.
Nah, I don't know.
Go Because we don't really give a rat's ass out fucking Hammer Magoo over there.
No.
Let's get Hawaiian. Look who's here. You're that Eldo fellow from Artira, ain't ya? Guess we both got ourselves marked for the exhibition. Were you hoping to stay in this inn? Sorry to disappoint you. So, because I just got tossed out on my ear by the innkeeper. Said it's already full, and the one calling himself the Come One Come All Inn. Some joke, eh? Gotta be insane. It sure is. Is there another place nearby to stay? There's two other inns nearby, but I'm hardly thrilled with either option. On the other side of the fountain is the Golden Coral Pavilion, where knobby wankers like Forden stay. A Parapis or an Elda staying there? Ha! Fat bloody chance. And there's an inn past the Golden Corral, but that one's twice as pricey. Rumors say that's where you'll find Luis, naturally. Probably bought out the whole place for his rabble-rousing crew. You think so? Guess we better avoid that one, then. Not like we could afford it to begin with. As far as other options go, there's the Spider's Den over by the tavern. There's a dodgy-looking Ujeev standing in front of it, smiling all creepy-like. Puts me right off staying there, so I'll pass. Besides, who needs an inn where there's a tavern? From this day on, I claim it as my castle. I doubt we'd get much sleep in a tavern. I sure wouldn't. Anyway, not that this Spider's Den sounds much better. Well, that doesn't help. I saw you at Martira, didn't I? Another participant in the tournament, right? Were you planning on staying at this inn? Unfortunately, there aren't any beds left. Because of the exhibition, everywhere is full up. And after I told myself I was going to make sure to stay somewhere nice this time, too. That's so. If this place is no good, we'll have to look somewhere else. But wait, that gauntlet runner of yours. The one you had parked in the middle of Martira. Hey, come on. What sort of technology does he use? Let me in on it, too. It's a secret. Wow, stingy. And here I was going to tell Dad all about it. Just so you know, I'm participating too. I've got a real gauntlet runner of my own and everything. That means that if you're stubborn and refuse to tell me, I can make you do it by force.
Good luck.
Dude, you barely come up to my junk. Get out of here. You're a child. You there. You have a look about you like one of my supporters, are you? Who are you again? You truly haven't heard of me. Oh, I am shocked. And yet, how lucky you are to be granted the privilege of my exquisite form for the first time. Beauty is all, is my creed, and more than anything, a king should be beautiful, should he not? And whichever inn I choose for my beauty rest must be worthy of my resplendent grace. Yes, like this Golden Corral Pavilion. Alas, I doubt you have been blessed with the wealth enough to enjoy a room at such a lavish place as this. This guy's a jerk! I wouldn't want to stay at an inn full of people like him anyway. Unfortunately, all the other decent inns seem to be full, so we've only got one choice left. We really don't want to, but should we check out this Spider's Den we heard about from Loveless earlier? Just stay in the Gauntlet Runner. Who cares?
I was going to say, I would actually just rather stay there.
It's got blood in its face. Who said that? This inn looks pretty shady, but I'm not sure we got any other options. Let's talk to that man over there, probably, before we go in. I think he's the innkeeper. Probably. Oh, on the hunt for lodging, are we? I have a spare room available. I won't refuse service to anyone, and my rooms are affordable for all. Criminals? Persecuted tribes? Oh no, I wouldn't dream of turning business away. Feel free to have a look at our accommodations. We can discuss payment afterwards. Oh, this place really seems shady, but we might as well look at the room. We're gonna get mugged.
That's what I'm thinking, like, they're gonna take our shit.
Not like we have much, anyway. Ah!
Did you see that giant bug just now? It was like the size of my head. It's gotta be poisonous.
Fine.
No, pull yourself together. It's just insect.
Well, listen to you. You can't have lived in a giant sandworm den and been afraid of bugs, surely.
Don't.
The hut.
That's why you lived in that hut.
Indeed.
Joanna will admit to the crime. The guilt of a sancturess, especially of her status, will guilt Forden by association. That should make an impression on Luis.
Hopefully.
For all this, we need Joanna herself. Do you truly think she will join us?
If she doesn't get killed beforehand, we have to trust her.
She
chose to offer her own head instead of the monster's. If you ask me, she'd not have done that if she didn't believe it truly was her child. At least in part. I believe she expressed genuine parental love. I want to believe that, at least.
And what if she ends up not showing up? I mean, you're the one who got the worst of all of this in the first place.
If it comes to that, you've still got my head for the dais. After all, the bounty still says I'm a kidnapper.
Balderdash will not sacrifice an innocent life for our victory. But your offer speaks highly of your spirit.
Right. We've done what we can do. All that's left is to keep our chins up and face the competition head on.
Indeed. I'll fly directly to the forehead.
Too early yet to retire for the night. We could drop by one of the local pubs. Listen for what perks our ears. And while we're at it, might as well sit down to a proper supper, eh? Could be my last, after all.
Shut up.
Oh, haha, very funny. But I guess good info is important. Let's go check it out.
Also, I don't know why Galica's scared of bugs. She flies.
Because she's not flying when she's sleeping. The bug is like the size of her head. She'd be freaked out, too.
Hey, Katarina.
Is everything, and it is time our country reflected that.
Sounds like the candidates have started their speeches. Let's listen in for a bit.
Why? I'm trying to punch him.
With all skills and talents equal, would you see the crown atop an ugly head or a handsome one? Beauty is power. Lack one, you should lack the other. When I take the throne, all the hideous will be stripped of their titles. Together, we shall build a nation ruled only by radiant, everlasting paragons of beauty.
And I love you too, random citizen.
What people tend to follow.
What? This really doesn't bother you. It isn't right.
You'd rather wait for a king who was always right, then?
Enough about appearance. A beautiful face cannot win wars. Without military power, the crown's voice means nothing. When I am king, I will establish a unified nation with the Roussant tribe at its head. Our tribes, our status, they mean something. You could stray from a monolith, but it will still remain. There can be no true peace without using the power we command. Hear, hear! For Roussant pride!
Shut up.
What pride is there in seizing power by force? Disgraceful.
When I'm queen, all the land's corrupt upper classes will be wanted men. We'll have our guillotines sharpened and our wallets open. Those who thought to tilt the world with their heavy coffers will be a head lighter. We'll split their fortunes and toast to our health.
Preach it, Katharina. You're just what this land needs.
Wouldn't the first target be the one on the throne, then?
Yes.
Everyone's just shouting all their ideals out.
These candidates are all pathetic.
Kill them all.
Nobody here even compares to Lord Louise.
Louise isn't even in the running, lad. Poor Blight is afraid of losing to Sanctifex Ford.
You've got it backwards, geezer. He's just not wasting his time on these windbags.
I confess, I know not how to feel.
Who cares?
Tis unprecedented. Never before have our citizens come together in the street in broad daylight and shared their true feelings on king and kingdom.
Also true.
Indeed. Is this really the kind of change His Majesty wanted? Maybe I'm overthinking it.
Let's go in. If we hang around too long here, we're bound to get dragged into a nasty argument.
Fishes. Cute bar maidens. Loveless.
The dude in purple jacket was on the other side.
I don't care.
Block and a flag can drink all year round.
Who's paying for it?
Let fools be content with their fool dreams. Grant me the crown, and I will make our kingdom powerful beyond imagining.
You taking it from Louise?
Don't really mean anything, does it? Aren't you another one of Louise's flunkies, hound? Stop barking and get back to your master.
Damn.
Always about that goddamn Louise. I've been in the guard just as long as he has, you swine.
Yeah, but you suck.
Quite a lively crowd. Looks like a great many of them came all the way here to watch the competition.
And watch it they shall.
He's an elder, isn't he? Are you a candidate too?
Who's asking?
Strike me down, you're right. Never seen one of you blokes before. Might be out of luck in the race, though. You'll not stand a chance.
Pay him your mind. A drunk's words weigh nothing.
Wow. There are fish swimming in front of the store.
We eat them.
Ah, I've heard of this. It is on the customer to fish up a catch, and the chefs will prepare it for eating.
I admit, I'm curious. Shall I sing a shanty for you as you take up rod and reel, Captain?
No. Yes, I guess.
Oh. Oh, we don't actually fish, though. Ah!
Throw it back!
Throw it back!
I caught some weird, creepy creature.
Oh, God. Ah!
It...
really edible? It doesn't look quite...
Here, Hulkenberg, you can have mine. Out.
Why, it is delicious.
You're an idiot.
The aroma of the sea simply floods the mouth. Ah, and what splendid crunch it has.
I guess I'll try a bite. I mean, they wouldn't let us fish up anything outright inedible. I hope.
At least we'll die together.
Well, I was the one who suggested fishing. Right. The noble thing to do is see it through.
It's just eating lip.
It's rather slimy for my liking.
I said nothing since Hulkenberg seemed to enjoy it so much, but if you're going to eat an unknown fish, might you not at least sear it first?
Maybe.
Fine enough without, I say. You need way higher standards, lady.
Yep. Hulkenberg is the ravenous Hulkenberg.
Excuse me, friends. Don't mean to interrupt your meal. I'm Batlin, a church crier for the tournament. Maybe you remember me.
Who?
Sounds like you made a hell of a splash in Martyra, huh? Felling a vicious beast is one thing, but not many candidates took it figuratively.
I had to do something.
The candidates had to find themselves ahead for the lineup. Rather struck me when you all broke away from the pack so soon. So, do you have a head ready?
I do.
Well, let's see. Got a head right here, I suppose. Lips sealed, huh? Well, I'm certainly looking forward to the exhibition then. Especially considering the diversity of your little party. Always prefer to chase an interesting lead over a sure bet. Can't help it, I'm afraid. So, I'll have a keen eye out for you. Alright?
Alright. Just don't fuck me in the end.
That crier's an odd one. Not really what you'd expect from a Sanctus promoter. Who is he?
Final boss, maybe?
I don't know about that.
Aw.
Rumor has it that young candidate hasn't brought a head. Wonder what he's playing at.
Don't worry about it.
He's about to get a sharp lesson in the ways of the world, poor lad. I think he's worth keeping an eye on. Keep it under your hats, chums. But his power may rival Count Luis. I think he's just the ingredient we need to spice this race up a bit.
Battle boss?
Maybe. Oh.
Just got back from the pub, did you? You wound me. Nobody trusts a radical, huh? I expect you'll see for yourself.
Joanna and Barden should reach the city by morning. and I imagine they will aim to find us in our Gauntlet Runner. Nira sought to be there to greet them. When the day dawns, we should head to the Gauntlet Runner. No!
No!
My poop!
The luck, no luck.
The poop. The poop.
Mm-hmm.
So there's three more lineage lines left to get. Bye, nice tea. I'm done for the day. Shall I retire?
I sleep. Good night.
You rest well, Galaga.
Time marches on, and the age of the king draws nearer. The man sloshed again.
What happened to waiting for our guests? You utter buffoon! Is this why you volunteered to stay behind?
Nah, man. Fucking footsteps, darkness, ghosts and shit.
Seems like Joanna and Barden aren't here yet.
Oh, I feared this might happen. And we've no other head to offer the judges. It's a precarious position.
That's all. They'll come.
No. They'll come.
Ah, I'm going to splash some water on my face.
She's probably already in here. Yep.
My sincerest apologies. I wasn't expecting anyone to come in. You see,
I had my massive schlong in hand. I was taking the piss.
How did you come to be here? Explain yourself.
I walked.
Is something the matter, Barden? They were here the whole time?
I'm so terribly sorry. We heard the Gauntlet Runner had a washroom, so we thought we'd freshen up a bit.
Why? You're gonna die.
Was resting in the back room, contemplating my final day as a sanctuary.
Sir Nurus over there very decently let us into wash up.
I couldn't stand it, old thing. Her heart would bring any right-thinking man to tears. Could have run like a ballet thief in the night, but here she is, washing away her sins. It was more than a chap could bear, I say. Needed a drop of the grape and grain just to get myself through it.
The bottle's barely any emptier. Was a drop really all it took to get you drunk?
Oh, please do not blame the poor man. Talking to him has eased my heart for the trials to come. I cannot let myself betray you and regress to my vile delusions. I only sought to atone with myself before my sins are duly punished.
Yes.
I understand. Thank you for coming. Then, as we agreed, please confess before the crowd when the time comes. To be honest, I'm hesitant to turn you in now you've genuinely decided to repent. I mean, we're hardly icons of virtue ourselves. In fairness, you're a woman of status, and it'll be a big crowd. We're not looking to instigate a public stoning here. You can explain yourself freely, in your own words. We can't ask anything.
Thank you. Truly, I've felt so much more at peace since last we spoke. The fog has...
A fog, huh?
Thank you for everything. I do hope you win the throne.
No, I intend to.
Yes, I intend to.
Ah, I'm gonna be king.
The crown goes to. We're at least going to make sure it isn't used for evil.
Ha!
At last, it seems our preparations are set. We only trust that our plans will bear fruit.
I'm gonna dunk on you there, Stroll.
Thank you all for waiting. The very first round of the tournament for the throne, the exhibition of the brave, is about to begin.
All right.
Our monarchs to be will now present to the people the heads they seize to demonstrate their power. Worthy of the throne. At a later date, when the second round is announced, the faces on the king's rock, that is to say, the candidates with the top 20 approval ratings, will pass the first round.
20? 'Tis a great many eliminations in but one round.
I was hoping we'd at least make it through the first, but it might not be that simple.
Yeah, we're fine.
And now, ladies and gentlemen,
look at those church losers.
Rise to the lineup of all the gorgeous faces at the judges' table, starting with his and her highnesses of Oceania and Montario.
Oh, it's her ladyship. Lord Montario's here too, eh? And the armor on that fellow over there? A general, is he?
And of course, we have the one, the only, the people's favorite, our guest from the Sanctus Church, better known as the Miracle Saint, healer of all ills, presenting the lovely Lady Rella Cygnus.
Saint? Who's this? Someone fill me in. I've been literally living in a hole.
A brilliant healer. We've met, though a long time ago. Even as a student, she was already considered the kingdom's best in her field.
Looks like the crowd's on your side, milady. Can you give us a few words about what's on your mind as you take on the judge's mantle?
Well, I'm afraid you've rather got me on the spot. Hello, all. This city sure has, great seafood.
It does.
And, well, sea creatures. Fascinating, aren't they? There's so much we still don't know about them.
You suck.
Oh, I did hear about a legend of some monster in the eastern seas of Oceania. Imagine, the mind races. I'm hoping I can investigate those sightings.
While okay, okay.
That's just great, Lady Rella. Stop you there, clocks ticking and all that. But we're thrilled you're enjoying your stay.
She's evil, though.
I hardly believe you're my sister. Still not much of a public speaker, are you?
Oh.
So she's a saint.
Well, she seems like a nice enough lady.
We better stop worrying about her and focus on ourselves. I don't see Luis anywhere, but I bet he's got eyes in the crowd.
I wonder how this is gonna go. All right, I wonder who got what.
First up is a respected gentleman of the church.
He just got a fish.
The head of the monk soldiers of the crown theocracy.
I got a big dopey fish. Does he look that dangerous? Just fucking big fish.
I've no taste for needless killing. Therefore, I chose a mark with meat. Abundant. After the judging, it will be served in a banquet for the poor.
Interesting.
Stand up, fellow, my good
people. He's smart. He's fucking too smart. Not strong, but too smart.
Now, is there anyone who can talk
this? I brought two fish. A fucking big turkey.
Where's your proof? Yes, the young sod's right. How do we know that's really a human?
What drivel? Look at the thing. You think a normal beast could have a face like this?
Yes.
You just made the damn thing yourself.
Oh, useless as ever. Did it never occur to him that the average citizen has never seen a human?
Loser. This is a turkey.
Now, on to the next.
Oh.
Why are they just getting fish?
I don't know. They couldn't get anything else, I guess.
The size of that thing.
took the beastie down? Who did the deed?
I did it. It was me.
I heard tell of a monster tormenting the people of this beautiful port city. I could do no less than grant them respite from their suffering. Such is the duty of those with power. Who expected anything less? His Eminence Borden is simply in another class. Suddenly the critics have all gone quiet. All I hear is gratitude.
Fish, fish, fish. She's like, I want, she was like, I wanted to go see that. It's fine.
Is it though?
If he'd gone after us, the reaction would mean we'd have been written off no matter what we presented. Let's count ourselves lucky and trust in our strategy. Now, now, no dirty looks, you lot. Next is the Pagan Assassin's Prize. Let's see what head we've got now.
Hmm.
Explanation. Now, we've had quite a succession up here, but our last is coming up now. This should wrap up our show. Now, if the last candidate, the elf.
All right, let's see how this goes.
Please join us on the stage.
Where's the head?
Oh, he's not happy about this.
Your pardon, madam, but would you happen to be the Lady of Martyra? Joanna, the Sanctuaress?
Indeed. The head they've brought is mine.
The impudence. You dare offer an honored lady of the church before these judges. This is not to be borne. I've got something to say to you, too. That you chief there. Isn't that Heisme? The same damn criminal you were supposed to be chasing?
Yes.
The infamous Heisme? Are you chief of all things?
This. After we saved your hide on the road.
Do we bear? He started it.
He may be a former knight, but now he's a heinous criminal who stooped to kidnapping. Anyone who claims themselves his ally should be disqualified on the spot.
Shut up.
Please, wait. I have something I must confess to you all. You speak of the kidnappings that terrorized my home, Martyra. I am here to confess that the true culprit behind those atrocities was me. I was the caretaker of a hideous human in the basement of my castle. And to feed it, I abducted the innocent people of my own.
What? Absurd. Speak sense.
I killed them.
Master Heisme is innocent in all this. He was framed for crimes performed by my hand and in my name.
And I, Bard, captain of Martyra's Guard Corps, stand to vouch for all that she said.
Just so. It was this young candidate who killed that human, cleared me of the false charges, and dispelled the shadow over Martyra.
Thus, here I stand. My head is his to offer.
That's... well, that's quite a turn of events! We have our head, ladies and gentlemen! And it's unlike any we've seen yet!
Damn right.
How is this believable? She's an imposter. She's got to be.
Of course. That, oh, they're putting words in the poor woman's mouth. A Sanctuaress would never.
What will his eminence fall and do?
What are you gonna do, old man?
The honorable Master Godot should know whether I and my words can be trusted.
Uh-oh.
It is true to the last word, isn't it?
Yes, your eminence. Without question.
Young candidate. You have done well to bring about her repentance. Now, justice must be rendered.
What? Right here and now?
Yep.
Your Eminence, a moment!
Thank you for your concern.
but I have no objections. For a sinner like me, to confess the truth to the people has already been more than I deserve. O new king, it is my hope that you will rid the world of its twisted prejudices and common cruelties.
I'm gonna try.
Leave this country armed with the truth.
I'll do my best.
I will do my best.
Oh shit. Indeed.
If Sanctifex Forden turned in the biggest head, then our dark horse here has certainly turned in the heaviest. What an upset, ladies and gents! Who could see this coming?
That's right.
Those crazy kids have done it again. What a show!
You are evil, dude. You just have to be.
Oh.
We're all the way down to 49. After the events of the exhibition, many people seem to have taken notice of me. I hope this eventually leads to saving the prince.
Flames day.
Evening.
Barden just departed, wishing everyone well. I suppose he aims to reach Martyra before Joanna's confession does.
And Forden himself. I hardly expected the man to make himself so visible.
Likely his attempt at redirection. Keeps the blame from falling on him and the church. Can't say it didn't work, I suppose.
Mm-hmm.
Certainly not blameless in this either. It was my suggestion to make an impression by foregoing the pursuit of a monster's head in favor of a person's.
I guess, but...
Nevertheless, the Lady Joanna entrusted her final wishes to us, and we mustn't betray them. That's all we can do, really.
Mm-hmm.
Not bad, Pops.
Hey.
We were passing on the course of a human hunt. You gave a most distinctive show.
My lord.
Seems worth introducing ourselves to. I'm Fidelio, that's Basilio. Luis's right-hand man, see?
You're on the left, though.
And now you walk with a Ujif at your side. Each ally of a different tribe. Fascinating.
Better to have dependable friends than familiar ones. Something we've got in common.
Mm. Not only did you expose a failing of the Sanctus Church, but you dared to bring her alive so Forden himself could do the grisly part before all his flock.
Damn right.
That was not our intent.
Sure it wasn't.
Same idea, yeah? A real person's head gets more eyes on you than some decapitated beast. And now you're the names on everyone's lips, aren't you?
Yep. Right.
Right. It worked for her.
Well said. It's quite a feat for a no-name candidate to so deftly rub Forden's face in the dirt. A wake-up call, I'm sure, for those who only know his honeyed words.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Lord Luis, we really should be going.
Relax. They're in the middle of a conversation.
I like a show of strength as much as the next girl, but I do so hate violent spectacles. A view from the sky sounds so much more enchanting, don't you?
Back off me, woman.
Expected him to reach such heights.
Do you suppose we have his attention?
Well, we do.
He told us we had to demonstrate our power first. I'd like to think that if he went out of his way to talk to us, that's something we earned.
Indeed.
Hmm.
Oh, loves. I've got a message from Count Luis. He says he'll be sending a messenger along soon. So stay in the city, would you?
Okay. Well, hello. She got sure her fucking kunai with chain.
Master Luis was just here. What happened?
He loves me more than you.
Well, he just left. You weren't told.
Oh, boo hoo.
You better be getting back as well. Damn it. What's so special about those fools?
You brought a turkey head. You're a fucking goon.
Luis is having a go for Popeye, eh? Are you officially all flunkies in arms now, then?
Maybe. Not a done deal.
It's not a done deal.
Still, it is a significant step forward. We've crossed a dangerous bridge, and the risk paid off. We have finally taken the first step in saving His Highness the Prince. If we can get the formula, then we yet have a chance of lifting the curse.
How fares His Highness, anyway? He still fights?
I took a look in the Farsight Mirror a while ago. He's still asleep. Nothing's changed about his condition.
And do we know where this formula is?
Nope.
No, but he's bound to keep it somewhere secret if it's evidence linking him to the assassination. Still, a formula would be useless unless it's within arm's reach for emergencies.
If it's something he'd keep close, then...
It's engraved on his body, probably.
Maybe he's engraved it directly on his...
Yeah, somehow I doubt he'd literally carve incriminating evidence onto his skin. It'd be backwards in a mirror, besides. It's more likely to be in his runner.
Do you really suppose it would be in the runner he uses even today? The incident was near a decade ago.
Maybe.
It's as good a chance as any. Getting inside would be a pain for anyone else, including us.
He said he would send a messenger. Perhaps it would be wise to wait until we've heard his missive.
Good point. Let's just wait for word then.
How long must we wait?
Good.
Late night.
Joanna, a backwater sanctuarist denies me my moment of triumph.
Neener, neener.
She defiles the very church itself. Oh, and naturally it was an elder of all people who stood her before me. Will that benighted tribe never stop docking my heels?
Yeah, you suck.
An idea occurs, Your Eminence. For the tournament's next challenge, let us center the competition on a show of piety. Make them prove their Sanctus faith. After all, Sanctism is the state religion. It would be the barest of leaps to suggest that loyalty to the church is loyalty to the state.
I assume you have a plan.
Altaberry is our next destination. The very seat of the faith outside the capital. I thought we might propose another hunt. This time for relics.
Ah, the so-called divine relics. Those false idols the pagans consider relics of their gods.
What need does the world have for gods beyond our? Soon, they will talk of nothing but how to win the Sanctus Church's favor. Your Eminence's influence would be sure to reach even greater heights.
And in the pagan lands, the greedier candidates will plunder and pillage for idols as they see fit. Find footholds for our missionaries, all without getting our hands dirty. The collection of divine relics should be a spectacle held on Saint's Day. Our divine right will be undeniable. Once I take the throne, I will re-establish that these relics originally belonged to the Sanctus Church, and that they were ransacked from us in the course of history.
Nice.
Your Eminence, on that day, I should be grateful to be honored with a proper title.
No.
Say no more. A concession only fair for the right hand of the Sanctifex.
Ever at your service. You do not bow your head.
Oh, I... Humblest apologies.
What troubles you, my child?
Well, my concern would be about the risks involved. Some theories suggest even the royal scepter was originally one of these relics. In the unlikely event that a divine relic were to be found to nullify the king's magic...
If such a relic existed, it would have been found long ago. You burden yourself with such fears. All you need to do is be a good saint. Smile, wave, and bless.
Rella, you are to return to the royal capital and gather the people under my banner.
Understood.
Time marches on.
She better betray them for me.
A new king draws nearer.
Water's Day.
Hello. A word. Some odd blighter left a
man.
Mm-hmm.
Prowler, today, come. Bit curt, if I'm honest, seems like this night prowler place is some sort of pub or club. But do you know where it is?
Nope.
On the city's outskirts. Seemed fairly dingy to my eyes. I can't imagine Luis had a haunt like that.
Do you think it's a trap? Maybe he's caught on to us?
Maybe he hasn't.
If he wanted to trap us, I doubt he would make it so obvious. Though that doesn't guarantee our safety there, of course.
We have little other option but to show up.
I'll hang about in the runner. Keep myself busy with tinkering. But let me know if you talk yourself onto Luis's craft, eh?
Right. I'll see what I can do.
Let's be off to this night prowler.
The night prowler, huh? Place should be on the edge of town. I've heard the ferryman should know how to get there.
All right, then.
Let's go.
All right, let's check out the old Merchant's Bazaar. Yeah, we need that. Oh, we need that.
All right, then. Let's go.
Young man,
got a deal on today.
Give you more money for your mag. How much? Huh. Let's do it. We need the cash. So now we have zero. Count them. Zero. Mag.
All right, then.
Let's go.
Something to do with archetypes. This is 100% something we're probably never going to take off. This gives the whole party 50% more archetype experience.
Hmm.
So, yeah.
Oh, it was a good thing you did that today since it was raining.
Yeah. But I waited. Alright. I'm going to call the video here. Until next time. As always, if you like the series and you want to see more, like, comment, subscribe, ring that notification bell. And follow me on Twitch, ArcNova3. Until then.
Till then.